for grabs is the power in the Senate and the House of Representatives, which right now both have a very slim Democratic majority. All 435 seats in the House of Representatives are on the ballot, as well as one-third of 100 Senate seats. The focus on the Senate boils down to four states, starting off here in Nevada, Arizona, Georgia, and Pennsylvania. Analysts have said that for Democrats to retain majority in the Senate, they need to win at least three of those four. And in all of those four, polls show they are a very tight race, ranging from 1 to 3 points apart, and anything can still happen. The top issues resonating with PhilAm voters: crime rate, inflation, and abortion rights. There are PhilAms across the U.S. running as well, none higher than California Attorney General Rob Bonta, who is seeking to get voted in that post that he was appointed to just 2 years ago. The state of New York could see its first Filipino state assemblyman with Stephen Raga. And in Southern California, blind Filipino lawyer Oli Cantos is seeking a council seat in the city of West Covina. This election will also be a clear barometer for former President Donald Trump and for President Joe Biden, whose ratings have been dropping recently, and he's down to a 40% approval. But what's up next for him in the next 2 years will be determined by the midterms. As for former President Trump, he's already hinting that he will make a major decision come November 15. TJ Manatok, ABS-CBN News, Las Vegas, Nevada.